Hi everybody, Mike Bates from Refined Fitness Studio. Today we are going to go through the circuit that we get a lot of our clients set up on. So this video kind of serves two purposes. One, it's a good refresher for people that are going through the circuit, that just want to check form and again, just do a review. And for people that for whatever reason haven't had an opportunity to learn the circuit, they can watch this video and it's a good way for them to get started. But it's definitely should not replace working with a trainer to actually walk you through it. But it is a good way, a good review and a good starting point for a lot of people. Okay, so keep that in mind as we're going through, because I'm gonna go through it fairly quickly because we're using this under the assumption that you've already gone through this circuit once probably with a trainer. So come on over, okay? So the first exercise, so our circuit is set up with six exercises. They're designed to be done in order, okay? Each exercise, we ask people to do it 12 to 15 times, one set of 12 to 15 repetitions on each exercise. A weight should be chosen that is challenging by the time they get to 12 to 15 repetitions. If someone can get through 12 to 15 repetitions easily, they need to increase the weight. It's really that simple, okay? So the first exercise is called the leg extension exercise. Great exercise for strengthening the front of the thighs, the knees, and the hips. So come on over here. Got a few adjustments on this which are really important, okay? So first adjustment is this seat here, and people forget about a couple things with this seat. So with our seat, you need to make sure you're lifting it up and back a little bit. So you're gonna pull out this lever here, and pulling this up, you can slide back and forth, okay? You're gonna have that set. I've got two holes showing. I know that that's good for me. You're gonna have this set so that my lower back is flat against here. Getting in, most people are gonna get in with your right leg first, your left leg after. Okay, I'm gonna sit all the way back. My lower back is nice and flat. I'm actually gonna move this back one for myself. And the idea here is that this red sticker that says pivot on it is in line with kind of the middle of my knees, okay? So this is in line with the middle of my knees. If I'm too far forward out here, it's gonna be in line with my thigh, and that's not where we want. That's actually putting a lot more stress on our knees, okay? 99% of the time, this does not need to be adjusted. It should be at the number two. If you happen to come over here and this is not at number two, you're gonna take your feet out, and you're gonna move this by pulling out this handle here, and you're gonna move this back and forth like so. But your feet need to be out of here. If they're pressing on the pad, it's not gonna work. So once I'm at number two, it's gonna lock in place, and you're all set. If you don't have a lot of flexibility in your knees, this position is gonna be difficult to get into, so you might just need to get out, right leg, left leg, no problem. Okay, so we want this set at number two, lower back's nice and flat, knees in line at the pivot point. From there, you wanna choose a weight, again, that we can do 12 to 15 times. If you're not sure where to start, start with one of the first two plates, okay? All of our machines give you the ability to add 5 pounds on. So most of the weights go up by 15 pounds using this pin. If at some point what happens is sometimes a 15 pound increase is too much for someone. So if I'm at working at 30 pounds and I find going up to 45 pounds is too much of an increase, I can add 5 pounds on. I'm gonna go up to 35 pounds instead of that big jump up to 45 pounds. So I'm gonna start at 45 pounds, okay? So for this movement here, yep, nice and tall. If you've seen any of our videos before, we're always talking about keeping that chest up nice and proud, keeping the shoulder blades back. That's constant for just about every single exercise. I really can't think of an exercise where that wouldn't be important. From here, you're gonna push up just to the point that your legs are almost straight, okay? So they're gonna keep just a slight bend, then we don't wanna lock our knees out all the way. Our feet are kind of in a neutral position. Some people like to pull their feet back, that's fine. I like to keep them in a neutral position. The main focus is right here, coming up and down, okay? Come up slow and controlled, down as far as we can. You notice the weights are not touching, okay? We don't want the weights touching on the way down. So slow and controlled, not locking the legs out. For most people, we're gonna be in this position here, pushing up. And again, slow and controlled. We're not getting any quick, ballistic movements. We're not dropping the weight as it's coming down. Okay, 12 to 15 repetitions, really good posture. You're gonna feel a burning in the front of your thighs. That's normal. It's called lactic acid burning up. At some point, that is gonna force you to stop, but a little bit of a burning sensation is very normal. any sharp pains are things that we want to look out for. That's not something that's normal, but most people are able to do this exercise without any major pain. For a lot of people getting out, we're going to turn to the side, and they're going to go. That's the leg extension exercise. Next on our list is the leg curl for the back of our thighs. A similar seat adjustment on here, where we're going to pick up, we're going to pick the seat up from here with our strap. We're doing back and forth. This, the leg curl exercise, the seat's a little bit heavier, so you might find it doesn't roll quite as smooth. But basically, the same idea in that we're going to have a seat. So I want my lower back to be flat. I want my knees to be in line with that pivot point. Okay? On this particular exercise, once that's set up, there's a pin over here. Michelle, if you come over here, there's kind of a little trick here. This, if I just try and pull on this pin, it might stick a little bit. So sometimes what we need to do is just pull up on this just a little bit and allow this to rest against our thighs. Okay? Again, 9 times out of 10, this is going to be set right where we want it at number 2, which is fine. If it's not set at number 2, you can adjust it by pulling this out. Like you do want your feet to be out here while you're adjusting that. Okay? So I can move it up and down. But number two for 99% of people is where we want it. So right foot, left foot, down. My knees in line with that pivot point, which is where we want. We'll check the weight, that's fine for me. I don't want to be in this position. I want to be in this position, up nice and tall. We're pushing this down as far as we can. For most people, we tell them we want the back of their calves to touch the seat. We're going to come up just before the weights touch, and back down. Okay, up nice and tall. Okay. The big things that happen on this exercise, besides just people going too fast like that, we want them to be slow and controlled. Over time, as the weight gets heavier, people start to slide down a little bit. And Michelle, if you come over the side here, you can see I've got a space back in behind here. What we want to do is make sure that we're staying up nice and tall, holding onto this handle, just focused on using our hamstrings during this act. Okay? So that's the leg curl. To get out, a little trick. So for a lot of people, Michelle, if you come over to the side here, this pin right now, for a lot of people, pulling this up is a little bit heavy. So what we suggest is pull the pin out and just use your leg to actually push that up. And then once you're in a position, let go, and it'll hold right there. Okay? So that's your leg curl exercise. The next one we're going to do is the lat pull down. Okay? It's a great exercise for your back muscles. The movement on here, we're going to be sitting down, we're going to be pulling back and squeezing our shoulder blades together behind us. Okay? So the regular weight adjustments, the seat's going to move up and down. We've got a red handle here, it will move up by pulling it up. To push it down, it's easier for most people to sit on it, then pull up the red handle, and then it will come down. Okay? Once I'm in that position, I want to pull this pad up so my feet are flat on the ground. Okay? So once I'm in position here, what I need to do is stand up and grab this. So I'm going to stand up, grip, and sit down. And from this position here, again, chest nice and proud, I'm going to get up nice and tall. My eyes are looking straight ahead or slightly up. I'm going to pull this back, squeezing my shoulder blades, and my chest is never dropping. So I'm pulling back, letting it come up. What we don't want is to allow our chest to drop like so. Okay, we want to stay up nice and tall with our shoulder blades back again. I can't pick an exercise where that isn't important. Okay? Common mistakes on this are that people will let their chest drop. They will lean back like this. You don't need to lean back on this exercise. The last mistake would be once someone gets to this point, they tend to push down with their hands. Just not necessary. The whole focus of this is elbows back, hands into your armpits, squeezing the shoulder blades, and there's no other movement. Here to here. Once you're done, stand up, and let that drop. Most people are not as tall as me, so what they're going to do is from here, sometimes, if you're on the shorter side, what you may need to do is kind of come over to the side and let it drop that way. And again, if you are shorter, you don't have the arm length to actually start, you may actually have to come over here, grip, and come and sit down. Okay? Here, out. Okay? Lat pull down, great for your back and actually your arm muscles. All here. Next exercise we're going to do is called a chest fly exercise. Most of our clients will start out at a number two. So underneath here, we can move this around. There's one, there's two. This one's set at, there's one, there's two. That's where we want it for most people. Again, the same weight adjustments. Seat, again, will come up this way. If I want it to come down, I'm going to actually sit on it and pull up, and that's going to bring me down. The focus on this exercise, again, is the chest. So we're going to push out, straighten our arm, and then just leave a slight bend in it, and the same thing on this side. So we want to have a slight bend at our elbow. We're going to be up nice and tall. We're going to bring these together, squeezing our chest muscles, and slowly coming back. If it's your first time doing this, we normally like you to keep your hands in front of your chest, mainly because coming back too far tends to stretch those shoulder and chest muscles out a little bit more than they need to be in the first week or two. So this is the movement here. Okay? You can see my arms are almost straight. If you want a slight bend in them, but they're almost straight throughout this movement. The main mistakes we see on this one are that people tend to bend their arms and allow their biceps to help with this. We do not want this movement, and people tend to kind of lean into this. Okay. Chest up solves all those problems. Okay, so with this movement here, we're really focused on squeezing those chest muscles as we're coming in. If this position here causes too much stress for your chest or your shoulder, all we'll do is move from a two to a one. You're just going to start out with what we call a shorter, a smaller range of motion right in this area. Okay? And for most people, this is more than, it's just fine working within that range. Okay? So that's your chest fly exercise. Some people will do an exercise called a reverse fly on this exercise. If you've been shown this exercise tends to have, just has a little bit more risk associated with it. So if you haven't been shown it, I really would rather you wait to talk to one of the trainers about this exercise, but ultimately that decision is yours. So we're gonna move this all the way back to number four. We didn't talk about why the seat is set properly. So while we're doing that chest fly exercise, basically we want our arms parallel to the ground like you're making a T. Okay, so our arms shouldn't be down here and they shouldn't be up here. Just about parallel to the ground. So that's where, as long as your feet are flat on the ground, you're coming straight across, you're gonna be fine. So for the reverse fly, I'm gonna be talking this way. So Michelle, you might wanna sneak around over here. So for this exercise, we're gonna grab onto the upper handles here, and all we're doing is we're pulling back, just level to our body, and coming back to here. Slow and controlled, we're not looking to see how far back you can come. There should be no lean back on this. We're just coming back so it's in line with our body, slow and controlled. Okay, slow and controlled. Again, we are not looking to see how far back you can come. We're not looking to use a lot of speed to get there. Slow and controlled. Because a lot of people have really tight neck muscles and upper back muscles, we won't even show this exercise. So just, if you're gonna do this one, just please be careful. Okay, plus the reverse fly. The next exercise is the chest press. Another great exercise for strengthening your chest, your shoulders, and the back of your arms, okay? So our seat adjustment is going to be set so that when we're pushing out from across the middle of our chest, okay? So I'm normally at about a two or a three. Sorry, that's gonna be lower. I'm normally at about an eight or a nine for this one, okay? Some people can put their feet there, some people like to put their feet on the floor. That really isn't critical where your feet are, as long as they're well supported. From here, what we do not want you to do is attempt to push out from this position. Most people do not have the flexibility in their shoulder to get into that position, so what we would prefer they do is use this foot rest. This is exactly what it's for. That's gonna push this forward. Now I've got the flexibility to start. In this position, I'm gonna come back so my hands are just in front of my chest. I'm gonna push out, squeezing my chest muscles, and back. Okay, again, the weights aren't touching. Back and forward. And one of the things we're looking for here is that chest stays up. So what we don't wanna see is this. That's not what we're looking for. We're looking for this position here, all chest. Okay? When you're done, you're going to use this footrest to set this back. So you're going to press here, hold on, slowly lower it, and push that down. For some people, and it's rare, but for some people, if this position is too difficult, you can grab onto this grip, and for some people, they do find this grip to be a little bit easier for them. In the big scheme of things, if this is easier for you, use this, if there's no problem whatsoever with that, okay? So that would be our chest press. Again, the main thing we're looking for on this, once the seat is set properly, I'm pushing from across my mid to chest, is that I'm not leaning into this each time, and I'm using that footrest, okay? Last exercise is the shoulder press, okay? So this exercise is great for strengthening the trapezius muscles, our deltoid muscles, all in our upper back and our shoulder area. As long as our feet are flat on the ground for this one, we're all set. Make my weight adjustment. I'll say for most people, this is probably the most difficult exercise for a couple reasons. One, it's the last exercise, so you're a little bit fatigued from what you've just done. We worked some of the muscles that you're using during this movement, the triceps in particular, were just used on this exercise, so you're kind of hitting the same muscle group twice, so that makes this exercise a little more difficult. And the third reason would be, we're not using these muscles a lot, so they tend to be a little bit weaker, because we're not reaching above our head a whole lot. So, seated, feet nice and flat. This grip would be considered easier than this grip. We're gonna use our foot thrust again to move this up. We're gonna grip onto here, and what we're doing, keeping that chest nice and proud, pushing up above our head, down nice and slow. No arch in the back. I'm not getting into this position here where my chest is coming up too much while I'm arching my back. This position here. And normally what happens with this one is the first 5 or 6 reps aren't too bad, but then your last few repetitions become pretty difficult. Okay, when you're done, if you can lower it without any problems, go to here. For some people, we do want them using that footrest to lower it. If this position hurts, by all means, try this position here. Could be a lot easier. If any of these exercises cause any sharp pains, any joint pain, anything that seems really out of the ordinary, we definitely want you to check with one of the trainers to make sure that it's kind of a normal soreness that we would expect. If it's not, we're going to want you to go and get that checked out by somebody, normally a physiotherapist, a chiropractor, or your family doctor. Okay, so that's our circuit. If you check out our other video, we're going to do a video just to review some of the major stretches that we'd like to see our clients doing. But that's a great review for the circuit. If you need more information, you can email me personally, and I'll get in touch with one of the trainers. Or if it's a quick little meeting that you need, just shoot me off an email, and I'm more than happy to help with just about anything. Okay, again, Mike Bates from Refined Fitness Studio. Thanks for visiting us today.